Hey, Frozen community! Today we're going to show you how to replace the ARCO cutter. The cutter is considered a consumable part. When the blade is damaged or the cutter lever becomes deformed, it needs to be replaced. Now let's get started. The tools we'll need are tweezers, a 2.5mm hex wrench, and a cutter module. First, on the touchscreen, tap Tools, then tap Manual Adjustment, and move the extruder to a position about 10 centimeters above the PEI plate. Next, tap extruder and set the nozzle temperature to 250 degrees. Once the temperature has reached the target, tap extrude 2 to 3 times to confirm that filament is coming out. Then tap retract to pull the remaining filament out of the extruder. After the filament is removed, clean any residue from the PEI plate and wind the remaining filament back onto the spool in a clockwise direction. That completes the unloading process. After filament unloading, turn off the power and unplug the power cable. Then remove the retaining clip on the extruder. Press down the PTFE clamp and pull out the PTFE tube. Place the tube on the side beam of the machine. Gently open the extruder's magnetic front cover. Use tweezers to unplug the blue terminal. Here's a quick reminder, if there's still anti-loosening protective glue on the blue terminal, you can use tweezers to peel it off first, then unplug the blue terminal. Once that's done, you can easily remove the front cover and set it aside for later. Next, locate the mainboard ribbon cable connection on the extruder. Slightly peel off the black acetate tape, then detach the ribbon cable clip from the nozzle heat pipe module and stick it to the side of the X-axis frame. Then, use a 2.5mm hex wrench to loosen the 3 screws on the nozzle heat pipe module and remove the module. Now hold the shaft pin with one hand, and with the other hand, press the cutter lever all the way down. Gently pull outward to slowly release the cutter lever until it's in a horizontal position. Finally, remove the cutter lever. Then take out the spring and you're ready to replace the cutter. Take out the new spring and insert it into the shaft pin. A quick reminder, when installing, make sure the short end of the spring fits snugly into the groove on the left side of the shaft pin. Next, take out the new cutter and cutter lever and attach the cutter to the U-shaped clip on the side of the cutter lever. After installation, gently lift the cutter upward. You're now ready to align the positioning screw on the cutter lever with the curved groove inside the extruder. Align the round hole at the front of the cutter lever with the shaft pin, and the flat hole at the back with the long end of the spring. Once aligned, install the cutter lever onto the extruder. Now press the cutter lever down so it's flush with the extruder. While holding it down, push the cutter lever forward and check that the positioning screw is securely seated in the curved groove at the lower right of the shaft pin. That completes the cutter lever installation. If the cutter lever remains in a horizontal position, it means the installation wasn't successful. Simply repeat the steps above and make sure the positioning screw is properly seated in the groove. Next, we'll install the nozzle heat pipe module. Here's another reminder. During installation, make sure the cutter on the extruder fits into the slot on the back of the nozzle heat pipe module. This ensures proper alignment. Start by aligning the nozzle heat pipe module with the left side of the extruder. Then use tweezers to gently adjust the cutter's position. Once the cutter is securely seated in the slot, close the nozzle heat pipe module. After installation, gently press the cutter lever to check if it can be fully pressed down. Also, check through the front cover's gap to see if the blade moves smoothly. If everything looks good, use the 2.5mm hex wrench to tighten the screws back onto the nozzle heat pipe module. Next, remove the mainboard ribbon cable clip from the side of the X-axis frame, reattach it to the nozzle heat pipe module, and stick the black acetate tape back in place. Finally, take the magnetic front cover, plug the blue terminal back into the extruder, and close the front cover. One last reminder, when closing the front cover, be careful not to pinch any wires. Finally, take the PTFE tube from the side beam, insert it back into the extruder, and reattach the retaining clip. And that's it, installation complete. And that's it for the ARCO cutter replacement tutorial. Hope you find this video helpful. Be sure to let us know if you have any questions in the comment section. Remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification for more exciting news from Phrozen. I'll see you next time. Bye.